वेलकम टू वीलर्न। वीलर्न में आपका स्वागत है। वी आर कवरिंग मैनेजमेंट कंट्रोल सिस्टम सेशन 12 सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड आर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, फाइनेंशियल सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ बैंक, रिस्क कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ बैंक, इंश्योरेंस कंपनीज, म्यूचुअल फंड, नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सर्विस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, द फर्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज एब्सेंस ऑफ इन्वेंट्री। नाउ द बेसिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ सर्विस इज दैट इट कैन नॉट बी स्टोर्ड। सो इफ it is not used at a point of time, they get extinguished at that point only. So a service provider company, they must aim to eliminate it, its unused services and unused capacity. The second is difficulty in controlling the quality. Even after the service is rendered, the quantification, it is subject to the nature. And it is very subjective. Another is labor intensive. Service organization primarily are labor intensive. So with the advent of technology also, the labor intensiveness, though it has decreased, but as compared to manufacturing, it is still more labor intensive. Multi-unit organizations, when we say, there are some service organizations which operate many units at different locations and which are relatively very small. So the similarity of these separate units, they provide a basis for comparison or analyzing budgets and performance evaluation. The last is supply of services. It cannot be increased in the short run. Though they are classified as intangible, but to produce these intangible services, an extensive tangible infrastructure, it needs to be created, which requires a lot of time and expense also. Now, financial service organization, when we talk about, in terms of Indian financial system, it basically comprises of the commercial banks or the financial institution. Even the capital markets and insurance company, they all have gone into a rapid transition. So there are certain monetary assets when we talk about. So most of these institutions, most of the assets of these institutions or financial service firms, they are basically monetary, and their nature is such that they can be easily converted into monetary units. The second is time period of transaction. In case of any financial service firm, the impact of action, they have a very short term and as well as they have a long term consequence also, and they are dependent upon the product which is being offered. Another is risk and reward. The risk and reward, they are the cardinal principle of any business, and they are more so pertinent in case of financial service sector. The return, they are the functions of the risk which are associated with a particular product. Lastly is the regulation. Financial services, they are highly regulated. When we talk about India, so the banks, they are regulated by RBI, and there are certain other banking laws also. When we talk about capital market, it is being regulated by the SEBI, and the insurance companies, they are regulated by various laws relating to insurance and IRDA also. Now there are certain characteristics of banks, general characteristics of banks. So the first, that is the relationship between the rate and the maturity. To a great extent, they are dependent upon the deposit volumes or the loan losses or the expenses in joint revenue and the transfer pricing. Now there are certain risk characteristics when we talk about the banks. Now risk has always been present in any kind of a banking system. So management of this risk has gained a lot of importance, prominence due to, first, there is a growing deregulation of the local market. क्योंकि deregulation हो रही है local market में, it is gradually the world market is integrated with the local market. Second is, बहुत ज़्यादा diversity है banking operations की. Lending or deposits, they are the main function of the bank. But recent years में क्या हो रहा है, bank they have diversified their activities into derivative trading, securities or corporate advisory services as well. Another is, because with the advancement of information technology, now more and more banks, they are getting into the mode of online electronic banking. So जो traditional banking का था वो scope तो cover होता ही है, which is providing for the bill presentation or payment services also. Now there are four types of risk which are like credit risk when we talk about banks. So credit risk when we talk, it is basically a risk which is associated with extending the loan and advances. अब ये जो risk है in the form of creditors of not returning the loan and advances is a huge risk in itself. Another is interest rate risk. So when we talk about interest rate risk, it arises because banks, they fix the interest rate on their resources and on the assets in which they are employed at different times. Because changes in interest rates, they have a significant impact on the net interest income. There is a lot of mismatch between the times when the interest rates on assets and liabilities, they are reset. Another is foreign exchange risk. क्या हो रहा है, because of the volatility in the exchange rate, it has increased the underlying reasons being the sharp swing in the imported commodity prices, or there is an increase in FII activities even in the local markets. So banks, they are running an open position in foreign exchange either in spot or forward markets as susceptible to the risk. Last is the liquidity risk. ये जो risk है, it arises from the fact क्योंकि banks, they finance long term assets. Long term assets are the loans from short term liabilities. Short term liabilities of banks are the deposits, thus subjecting them to rollover of refinancing risk. This risk is also very much inherent in those transactions where banks finance domestic assets with the foreign currency deposits. When we talk about role of management control system in containing risk, so there are banks and financial institutions, they have a unique and important place in economic system of a country. So any instability in the banking system, it has a lot of effect on the whole of the economic, even across the national boundaries. अब ये potential instability को देखते हुए, banks, they have created, through their in-functioning banking system, they have closely regulated their activities, their systems at two levels. The first is the macro level and the second is the micro level. Macro level regulations, they are basically the broad policy frameworks which are issued by the central banks and which are within which the banks, they have to operate. When we talk about micro level regulations, they are basically specified for a particular bank, which are designed by the top management of the bank and which in turn specifies the operating guidelines, the authority and the power of the management at various different levels. Now apart from these MCS, they are also, they pay significant attention to various other parameters. These parameters is establishment of internal control cultures which is within the organization. Another is internal control activities, they should be designed in such a manner and implemented in such a manner so as they address as an integral part of their daily operation. The third is the functional segregation of the duties and assignment of responsibilities should be clearly done. Furthermore, there should be establishment of reliable information system all across the banks. Also, control of information system and technologies is very, very essential. Then there should be effective channels of communication which needs to be established. Now there are activities which relate to monitoring for internal control processes and correction of deficiencies. There are risk identification and assessment processes also. When we talk about insurance companies, so there are basically two types of insurance company. Pehli jo hai life insurance hoti hai. Life insurance company, they are basically concerned with insuring the life of an individual. Now there are two types of policies which are offered by LIC companies, which are whole life and term insurance policies. जब हम whole life insurance की बात करते हैं, the person has to pay a premium for a certain period and he is insured for his whole life and the maturity value of the policy would be only payable at the death of the insured person to his inheritors or the beneficiaries. Whereas in case of term insurance policy, the benefits of the insurance, it is available for the term of the policy only. Beyond that, the benefits, they are not available. Under this kind of a policy, on the completion of the term, what happens, or upon the death of the policy holder, whichever is earlier, the maturity value of the policy, it would be paid to the beneficiary. Another is general insurance or the casualty insurance. This kind of a policy is basically concerned with the property and the physical asset. Now, a general insurance company, it basically collects premium and invests them and make payment to the policy holder for any kind of specified losses. So, general insurance policy, it provides a kind of a coverage for a short period, then it generally ranges to 3 years only. There are some policies which pay for claims made during the period. There are other pays for losses which are incurred during the period also. When we talk about insurance market structure, India ke context mein ya fir developing country ke context mein, insurance is very well recognized. Now the insurance industry in this particular case is also defined under two categories. The first is life insurance or dusra hai non-life insurance, which is generally categorized as general insurance. So recently kya hua hai, insurance business wo basically monopolized tha LIC se aur GIC se and its four subsidiaries when we talk about. Now the Insurance Regulatory and Development Act, it has opened its insurance sector to private players, even to the foreign equity participation of up to 26% of paid up capital is also included. When we talk about management control system or management control implications, तो सेंट्रल मैनेजमेंट कंट्रोल प्रॉब्लम इन एनी इंश्योरेंस कंपनी, बेसिकली जब लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी की बात करते हैं कि प्रॉपर एस्टिमेशन ऑफ प्रॉफिट्स क्या होना चाहिए उनकी, विच इज एसोसिएटेड विद द करंट प्रॉफिट करंट पॉलिसी, इट इज टू बी डिटरमाइंड. सो दे सेट अ प्रीमियम विच इज बेस्ड ऑन देयर बेस्ट एस्टिमेट्स ऑफ इनफ्लोज एंड आउटफ्लोज एसोसिएटेड विद द पॉलिसी. जो ये प्रॉफिट्स है किसी भी पॉलिसीज के, इट कैनॉट बी नोन अंटिल द मेच्योरिटी ऑफ द पॉलिसी हैपेंस, या फिर फाइनल क्लेम जब तक नहीं होता. बट व्हाट हैपेंस, मैनेजमेंट जो है उस टाइम तक के लिए वेट नहीं कर सकता टू मेक देयर कंट्रोल डिसीजन. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस वेरी नेचर ऑफ द इंश्योरेंस बिजनेस, प्रॉफिट्स दे आर नॉट कंसिडर्ड एज अ यार्डस्टिक्स फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस विद रिस्पेक्ट टू देयर करंट बिजनेस. Therefore, for control purposes, insurance managers, they give a lot of attention to expense control and product pricing. When we talk about product pricing, कोई भी इंश्योरेंस कंपनीज दे हैव लॉट ऑफ पॉलिसीज और जो कि बहुत ज्यादा टारगेटेड होते हैं हर एक लेवल ऑफ सोसाइटी के. एन इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी अदर देन कंटेनिंग बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस दे ऑल्सो कंटेन फीचर्स लाइक टैक्स सेविंग एज वेल और फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग्स भी होते हैं. नाउ फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द एक्चुअली ऑफ प्रीमियम देर आर सर्टन फैक्टर्स दैट नीड्स टू बी कंसिडर्ड. The first factor is the acquisition cost. When we talk about acquisition cost, it is the commission which is paid to the sales agent and the cost which is associated with the sales organization. Another is servicing cost. When we talk about servicing cost, it is basically associated with the collection of premium. Lapse probability refers to the probability that the policy would be cancelled due to नॉन पेमेंट ऑफ प्रीमियम. एक होता है इन्वेस्टमेंट इनकम. दीज आर द इनकम्स दैट विल बी अर्नड बाय इन्वेस्टिंग द प्रीमियम्स अंटिल द पॉलिसी इज पेड. नाउ द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ पेमेंट, व्हेन वी से फॉर द लाइफ पॉलिसीज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ पेमेंट, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द एज ऑफ द पर्सन हु इज बीइंग इंश्योर्ड एंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ हिज डेथ. इट इज बेसिकली डिटरमाइंड फ्रॉम मॉर्टैलिटी टेबल. Another is income tax and statutory regulations. There are income tax regulations for the insurance industries, which are significantly different from other industries. Another is required earning rate. When we say required earning rate, is the rate at which inflows and outflows are discounted to arrive at the present values. Another aspect is sales performance. When we say sales performance, अब तक क्या हो रहा था insurance business में, in India the monopoly business, but LIC, जब insurance sector it was opened up, there are sales which became the crucial factor. Now the management control implication, here is that apart from the core selling, there were efforts which were made for product development. Product development में हम क्या includes कर सकते हैं कि policy को design करने के लिए, so that it caters to the need of large proportion of the insurable population. Now there are expense control when we say. So there are general areas of insurance, but apart from these areas, the nature of the insurance business, it also implies कि वो investment या holding of assets में कितना उसका है. So in order to ensure that kind of control, actual liability of policy holders, they are met, the asset hold be managed in a very prudent manner. The risk return profile, they should result from an integrated view of the product, product underwriting or reinsurance policy. Now the management control system, they should focus on areas like asset liability management. When we talk about asset liability management, is a key driver of the asset strategy of any insurance company. It would be its liability profile. The second is the investment process. And when we talk about the investment process, it is depending on the nature of liability. An insurance company, they are likely to hold the following assets either directly or indirectly. The third is the risk management function. When we say risk management function, premium collection is a part of the insurance company where it is used to meet the expenses and for the purpose of settlement of the claim. But the remaining part, it is invested in various kinds of financial instruments. So the return from these investments, they are used to pay bonuses on policies or settlement of claims also. Last is the internal controls. There should be an adequate system of internal control which must be present to ensure ki policies or procedures jo hain wo follow kari ja rahi hain in writing and in spirit also. When we talk about mutual funds, म्यूचुअल फंड्स जो है ये एक इन्वेस्टमेंट इन कैपिटल मार्केट का एक मीडियम है एंड देर आर शॉर्ट टर्म मनी मार्केट इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स फॉर इन्वेस्टर ऑल्सो. When we say mutual funds, they are major type of investment companies, wherein investments companies, they are the financial intermediaries. Intermediaries means middlemen, they pool the funds of the investors, those who are seeking some general investment objectives, and invest them in the number of frequently traded types of securities. सिक्योरिटीज कौन सी हो सकती हैं? कॉमन स्टॉक हो सकते हैं, बॉन्ड्स हो सकते हैं. सो क्या होता है, दीज पूल फंड्स दे प्रोवाइड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इन्वेस्टर्स विद प्रोपोर्शनल ओनरशिप ऑफ डाइवर्सिफाइड पोर्टफोलियोज विच आर ऑपरेटेड बाय प्रोफेशनल इन्वेस्टर मैनेजर्स. जो ओवरऑल एक्टिविटीज हैं म्यूचुअल फंड्स की, दे कैन बी डिवाइडेड एंड कैटेगराइज इन टू फंड मैनेजमेंट, ऑपरेशन, कस्टमर सर्विस, सेल्स एंड मार्केटिंग. तो मैनेजमेंट कंट्रोल सिस्टम फॉर ईच ऑफ दीज एक्टिविटीज दे विल स्पैन अक्रॉस थ्री डायमेंशंस. वो थ्री डायमेंशंस कौन से होते हैं? वो होते हैं पॉलिसीज एंड प्रोसीजर्स, सेकेंड इज द सिस्टम, एंड थर्ड इज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, सो नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बेसिकली वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस होती हैं जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूट नहीं करते अपने एसेट्स और इनकम को या फिर बेनिफिट्स को टू इट्स मेंबर्स और टू द ऑफिसर्स एंड डायरेक्टर्स. बट इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि इन एम्प्लॉयज को सैलरी नहीं दी जाती. यस, दे आर गिवन सैलरी. नाउ देर आर सर्टन फीचर्स ऑफ नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. यहाँ पर पहला फीचर है कि देर आर एब्सेंस ऑफ प्रॉफिट मेजर्स. सो गोल्स ऑफ मोस्ट ऑफ द नॉन प्रॉफिट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दे आर बेसिकली इनटैंजिबल एंड क्वालिटेटिव इन nature. The second is some peculiar items. There are some peculiar items such as capital funds, annual subscription, life membership fees, government grant, entrance fees, donations, which are covered under this. Another characteristic is fund accounting. When we talk about fund accounting in non-business organization, there are at times they maintain separate accounts of fund for specific activities. So all the receipts and expenses related to the funds, they are not taken into income and expenditure, but they are adjusted directly to the specific fund account. The fourth is the governance. When we say governance, the non-profit organization, they are basically governed by the board of trustees. Now is the time for management control system. When we say management control system for any non-profit organization, they focus on product pricing. When we say product pricing, in any non-profit organization, the motive is not to earn profit, but to engage the activities which are related to the welfare or for the benefit of the society as a whole. Second is the strategic planning and budget preparation. Now what happened, jitne bhi non-profit organization ke resources then they are limited. The process of strategic planning, they should chart for the allocation of limited resources in all the worthwhile activities only. The third is the operation and evaluation when we talk. So in most of the non-profit organization, jitna bhi optimum operating cost hota hai, it cannot be predicted. To kya hota hai, there are certain budgeted amount which is spent without taking into consideration the merits or demerits of the activity. There are exercises that needs to be done. First, describe the unique characteristics of financial service organization, and second, explain in detail the various variables of banking system which affect the management control system of a bank. Thank you and have a nice day. Keep learning and be learning.